Hello, and welcome to eCraft. We have already posted introductory videos on how to program the first ever microcontroller RP2040, developed by Raspberry Pi Organization, using Arduino IDE. This is a dual-core microcontroller with lots of useful features, priced at an affordable range for the entire spectrum of the user base. The videos posted on this channel earlier explained using Arduino IDE to utilize the power of both the cores. In this video, we will explore a unique feature of the RP2040 microcontroller called Programmable I/O, or PIO for short. PIO is a piece of hardware that enables users to create custom I/O interfaces for time-deterministic applications without overloading the controller's main processing loop. The PIO subsystem in RP2040 allows you to write small, simple programs for what are known as PIO state machines. These state machines are responsible for setting and reading one or more GEOs. The RP2040 microcontroller has 8 of them, split across 2 PIO instances. These programs operate with cycle accuracy at up to the system clock speed. Please note that the RP2040 controller contains 2 separate PIO blocks, each of which has 4 state machines that can execute sequential programs independently. These PIO blocks have their own program sequencing hardware, which is separate from the 2 Cortex M0 Plus cores of RP2040. Therefore, when it comes to time-critical hardware interactions, the PIO blocks can operate independently from the main processor. Let's briefly examine the programmer model of a PIO block. The state machines of a PIO block typically operate independently, and system software interacts with them through DMA, interrupts, and control registers, just like with other peripherals on RP2040. For more complicated interfaces, PIO offers a small yet versatile collection of primitives that enable system software to have more control over state machine control flow. Each PIO is equipped with 4 32-bit bus FIFO in each direction, TX/RX, reconfigurable as 8-32 in a single direction, flexible GPIO mapping, instruction memory that can store 32 instructions, an interrupt block to generate interrupt to the main controller. Furthermore, each PIO contains 2 32-bit shift registers in both directions, 2 32-bit scratch registers, a fractional clock divider, and a DMA interface. Please go through the Chapter 3 in each of the documents, such as the RP2040 datasheet and the Software Development Kit manual, to obtain more information. The PIOs can be programmed using these 9 instructions as shown in the table. PIO instructions are 16 bits long and have the encoding as displayed in the table. The output shift register, OSR, holds and shifts output data between the TX FIFO and the pins or other destinations, such as the scratch registers. Pull instructions, remove a 32-bit word from the TX FIFO and place into the OSR. Out instructions shift data from the OSR to other destinations, 1 to 32 bits at a time. Another 32-bit input shift register, ISR, shifts 1 to 32 bits, 1 at a time into the register when an IN instruction is executed. Push instruction write the ISR contents to the RX FIFO. Shift directions for both OSR and ISR are configurable by the processor via configuration registers. Go through the documents referred earlier to learn more about the PIO programming instructions. In this video, we will walk through the entire process of creating a C++ program file from a .pio file that can be incorporated into an Arduino sketch. We will be using a single PIO to make the onboard LED of the RPI Pico board blink by running the program for the PIO on an Arduino sketch. While it may not be as straightforward as creating an Arduino sketch and uploading it to the board, once you become familiar with the entire process, it will be much easier the next time around. Assuming that you already have Arduino IDE software installed, download Pico SDK package from the link provided. This package contains PIOASM files for building a PIO program. To proceed, you will have to download and install CMake for Windows. You can find the download link provided here. The CMake file describes the process of combining a PIO file in an Arduino sketch into a program image that can be loaded into a development board based on RP2040. More information on the CMake package can be found in the RPI Pico C++ SDK manual. Next software needed to be installed is MinGW Minimalist GNU Makefiles for Windows. I have added the complete link for downloading and installing MinGW Makefiles in the description box and included the other relevant links there as well. In the folder, I have three items necessary for us to start building our first PIO program using Arduino IDE. First, I will install the CMake tool by double-clicking on the installation file. After installing the CMake package, create a build folder in the PIO ASM directory inside the tool's folder path shown. We need to copy the path of the build folder and save it for later use. Afterwards, we will run the MinGW tool from this location using the command prompt. Next, we need to install the MinGW software tool. This part was a bit tricky for me as the SourceForge link did not work. I have used another web page as a reference to download the MinGW tool. The link to this web page is also provided in the description box for your reference. The path environmental variable must be set as shown. You may also need to restart your computer after setting the path variable. Next, open the command prompt and go to the build folder in the PIO ASM folder. Run the CMake command as shown. Afterwards, run the MinGW32 make command as shown. We are now ready to create a PIO program. Instead of creating a new PIO program from scratch, we will use one of the programs available on the GitLab page. There are several PIO example programs available on the page, and we will begin with a simple one. We will be using the hello.po program. To get started, we first need to download the .pio source code. This code is written with the PIO program instructions. If you need more information on these instructions, please refer to the Raspberry Pi C++ SDK manual. Now, we should run the pioasm.exe command to convert the hello.po file into a C header file. The generated file can be used with an Arduino sketch. Please ensure that the file paths are correctly specified. Please note that the PIO ASM tool has generated the hello.po C header file from the hello.po assembly file. This C header file can be used in an Arduino sketch like a library. This is a straightforward Arduino sketch that relies on the hello.po header file, which is made using the PIOASM tool. It is worth noting that two header files are included in this sketch. The code is designed to make the onboard LED of the Pico board blink using PIO. In a loop, the LED will turn on for 5 seconds, then turn off for another 5 seconds. Let me upload the sketch into an RPI Pico board. Please note that this code will not work with the RPI Pico W board as the onboard LED is wired differently on the new Pico W board. Alright, the upload has been completed successfully. You should notice that the onboard LED will turn on for 5 seconds and then turn off for another 5 seconds. This cycle will repeat continuously. Judging by the outcome, it appears to be functioning as intended. I have found some useful links to help you get started with RO2040PO programming using the Arduino environment. These links are available in the description box below this video. Please note that the Arduino sketch used in this video can be found in the first link. Thank you for watching. Kindly consider subscribing to EECraft to support us.